Hi, explorers. My name is Brian, and I'll be your guide for the ultimate expedition we'll be undertaking this year, one that encompasses the entire globe. Today, I will introduce you to geography. We live in a world that is wondrous and diverse, full of inspiration both natural and human-made. Prepare for the journey of a lifetime. Have you ever been to an escape room? It's pretty thrilling, isn't it? Why do you think they get the adrenaline going? If for me, it's because I don't know anything about where I am. It puts me on edge. I have to discover the history of the room, become familiar with its layout, and I can only hope that it will provide me with the clues and tools I need to succeed. Imagine what it must have been like to be a human thousands of years ago, living in an unfamiliar world. In fact, take a second to respond in your PDF. Pause the video and find the lesson guide on page 3. It must have been scary to be born into a world you know so little about. Since the beginning, people have sought to become more familiar with their surroundings by sharing what they learned as they traveled to new places. Textbooks will tell you that geography is the study of relationships between people and their environments. And they're right. But I'd like you to think of geography as more than that. Let's try to imagine it as a way to take in the wondrousness of the planet, to marvel at it as you would a starry sky or a magnificent painting. Let's learn to think like a geographer, to seek out and make sense of the world's limitless beauty and variety so that you can integrate what you learn about the Earth and its people with what you already know about history, math, science, and art. The aim is to build a comprehensive understanding of our changing world so that you can grow to know it, to love it, and to take care of it. On that note, pause here to write 3 things that you'd like to learn about the Earth and its people in your lesson guide. For today, our learning goals are to explain how and why early humans used geography, to compare and contrast how geographic data was collected in the past with how it is collected today, and to explain how geography is used in everyday life. In the 6th century BCE, the ancient Greeks, the first to say that Earth was round rather than flat, were already traveling far and wide by ship using the stars to navigate. And by the 3rd century BCE, a scholar named Eratosthenes was able to accurately calculate the size of the Earth using only a measuring stick and simple math. He lived in Egypt, and he knew he couldn't walk around the Earth and measure it. But he'd heard from travelers about a well they'd seen in Syene, Egypt, which gave him an idea. Every year at noon on June 21st, the summer solstice, the sun would illuminate the entire bottom of this well without casting any shadows, meaning the sun was directly overhead. Eratosthenes then measured the angle of a shadow cast by a stick at noon at the same time in Alexandria, where he lived. He found it made an angle of about 7.2 degrees, or 1/50th of a circle, and realized that if he knew the distance between Syene and Alexandria, he could use geometry to calculate the circumference of the Earth. So, he hired some professional surveyors to walk in equal length steps from one city to the other, and these surveyors reported that the two cities were about 675 miles apart. He then calculated that the Earth must be about 24,900 miles around, which is pretty accurate. It was this man, Eratosthenes, who came up with the word geography. It comes from the Greek words geo, meaning earth, and graphi, meaning to write about. And that's literally what geography is, writing about the earth. As the Greeks and later the Romans traveled through the Mediterranean, they gathered lots of data about the people and places they saw. They used it to make detailed maps that displayed the world which lay beyond what was familiar to them. How do you think that making visual representations of the places they traveled to benefited them? Maybe you said people could point out places where fish are plentiful, or where there are good fields for growing crops. Curiosity about the familiar and the unfamiliar has been widespread for a long time, and the impulse to map, describe, and make sense of the world didn't begin with one particular group of people in one particular place. The same questions ancient people asked themselves, like, how far away is the neighboring village, how many people live there, and do they have anything I want, are not that different from the kinds of questions that modern geographers ask today. The main difference between then and now is the technology used to collect and analyze data. Long ago, people gathered data firsthand as they traveled. Today, the data is collected by professionals who use high-tech tools like sonar, satellites, GPS, and GIS. Sonar, which stands for Sound Navigation and Ranging, analyzes sound to determine distance and direction. Originally developed to find icebergs, sonar is now used to study the ocean floor. Satellites can record images of the Earth's surface from space, and geographers can compare older images with newer ones to find changes in lots of things, like this landslide in Mozambique. The Global Positioning System, or GPS, relies on a network of satellites that orbit the Earth which broadcast extremely accurate time signals back to Earthbound devices, like your phone or car navigation system, which then analyzes the signals to provide data about location. Geographic Information Systems, or GIS, layers lots of data together. In this example, GIS layers street data on top of building data on top of vegetation data and provides an integrated map of all three. In tandem with these new technologies, the purpose of geography has also expanded. As our world changes, it is more important than ever to understand what surrounds us. Can you think of an example in which it might be helpful for someone to have data about the world around them? There are many examples. Maybe you said zoologists would want to understand the environment where animals live so that they can help conserve their habitat. Growing populations have needs like food, water, and shelter that we rely on the Earth to provide resources for. Keeping track of what resources are available and what it will take to get them to the right place at the right time is a delicate balance requiring an orchestra of systems to run smoothly. Not to mention that the available supply of resources is changing as we use them up. And as other modern tools like planes and the internet connect people across the world, we want to share the resources we have with each other. Being able to collect data and represent it to each other is crucial for that economic development. So, geographers don't just collect and analyze data. Most importantly, they share what they learn with others. They communicate information to the public and to lawmakers that need to use it to make policy decisions. They work with ecologists to promote conservation efforts. And there are countless other examples. As there has always been, knowing about the Earth helps us to keep ourselves and our environment safe and working in harmony. Civilizations have followed their curiosity about the world since ancient times, mapping, measuring, and analyzing their surroundings to try and make sense of what's familiar and what lies beyond. As you move forward in your study of geography, we encourage you to seek out the unfamiliar. Find your place in your neighborhood, your city, your country, and think about what you see. Until next time, keep exploring. Hey, hey.